All right, guys, we're leaving Alamogordo, New Mexico. Leaving Alamogordo, New Mexico, and on the road, heading on over to Santa Rosa, New Mexico. Had to gas up, didn't get any help on gas from you guys on PayPal, so please support me $5, $10, $15, $20. Got gas here for $3.99 a gallon, which is
head west as toward cheap US 54 East, then turn right onto US 54.
As cheap as it's gonna get, that's as cheap as it's gonna get. So I support, please support me, paypal.me/ElvisTravels, $5, $10, $15, $20. I'd appreciate it. We're on the road. I think I'm going to drive another couple of hours and get to maybe, we'll see, we're going to go over the mountains. I want to go over these mountains here, get them over with, and get into hopefully Santa Rosa, New Mexico. That's going to be my stop, I think. Heading on 54 here. 54. So give me a 69 if you guys can hear me. We're leaving, we're coming up here in Alamogordo, New Mexico. We're gonna go 54 east. There's a split off here, 70 east. Is this it here?
Turn right on Charlie T. Lee MRR.
Trying to figure out if this is it. I'm trying to hopefully think this is it here. I don't know. This is 54. Really confusing when you get over to that. This is,
Continue on Charlie T. Lee MRR.
Yeah, this is US 54 here, getting into Alamogordo, New Mexico. Give me a 69 if you guys can hear me. I didn't get any support on PayPal. Appreciate $5, $10, $15, $20 for some fuel money. I don't know if this is 54 or if that's 54 up there, but we gotta get on 54 east here. It kind of curls around here, a lot of confusing curls. So I'm trying to figure out what's going on here. 54 east, where's that at? I'm gonna make a left here somewhere. I think this is it. We're coming up here on 54 east leaf route here, so I think we're going the right way. Give me a 69 if you guys can hear me. I think we got about 4.8 miles here. Get to something here. Want to check my fluids, guys. Power steering fluid was fine. Engine oil was a little bit low. Want to put a quart of oil. I needed a little bit of get a brake fluid, topped off my master cylinder of brake fluid, cleaned my windshield, and gassed up, topped off my gas for $3.99 a gallon, which is, you're gonna get gas for under $4 now. That's pretty much the deal. Anyways, I'm back on the road sharing with you guys using the Logitech headset here, the Logitech headset. Got my window open. And we're on the road here, guys. We're on the road. Got about miles here where there's going to curve off to 54. Good road here. Splits off.
going to be good riding here. I'm going to get over the mountains, get over Tularosa. Then once I pass, mountains are somewhere around here, I think. I'm going to get over those little mountains, little hills. Like mountains, over mountains. Everything's going good with me today. Good riding road 54. Hopefully gonna get into Santa Rosa, New Mexico tonight. That was my stop off last time that I got tired, so. Maybe I'll urban camp in Santa Rosa, New Mexico. Gotta get some good miles in here. Get in closer to Dallard, Texas. Get some good cool weather driving. If you guys can hear me and see me, please press the number 69. We're just coming up here, passing out the border of Mexico. 54 eastbound at the tolls of Mexico. And easing on in to going over the mountains, Santa Rosa. Santa Rosa, New Mexico. Long way to go home, 1,400 miles, 1,382. Not really start today. Hopefully going to get an early start tomorrow. That's the way it is when you're on the road. It's rotation time. Sometimes you do nights. Sometimes you got to get up and do days. That's the bottom line. Get into the plains for some cooler weather, get out of the desert. Santa Rosa, New Mexico is a desert, but I hope we can get into plains, get some cool weather plains around Dallard, down in Oklahoma, Dallard, Texas. We're coming up here on Exchange here, I believe. This is an exchange of some sorts here, some big is what it is.
Left lanes, then turn left on US 54.
US 54 is going to continue over here. Truck driving. US 54 east is what we want. Lots of curves, but US 54 East, there it is right here. This is a split off here, so we want to go towards Tularosa.
Turn left at the traffic light.
Yep, here we are, here's the exchange right here. I believe this is it right here. We're gonna make a left here, and this is US 54. Hey, how you doing, Tim? Nice to see you, brother. We're on the road here. Yeah, we're
continue on US 54.
Yeah, here it is. We are coming up here on the sign, 57 miles away from Carrazo, New Mexico. There's a truck stop here. There's a nice Dodge Maxi van with a handicap top. Looks like the Mexican Chihuahua plate on there. Nice to see the old Dodge Maxi vans on the road. 5.2 Magnum, 5.9 liter V8. We're going to be going over the mountains, guys. So if you guys enjoying the program, I know there's not much to see, but please give me a 69. Let me know if you can hear me. I can't read the messages because I got to keep my eyes on the road. I haven't seen any support on PayPal. I'd appreciate your support, guys. PayPal.me/Elvis Travels. The link is on the Assyrian Nomad Facebook. Hit me up with friends and family option, $5, $10, $15, $20 for fuel. We'll be greatly appreciated, guys. And press the number 69 if you can hear me. We're easing on in here into the mountains of New Mexico, heading towards beautiful Santa Rosa, New Mexico, and Route 66, eventually heading into Dalhart, Texas. Took gas prices under $4 a gallon, $3.95 a gallon, and then easing on into Gavin, Oklahoma, Liberal, Kansas, Hutchinson, Kansas, getting on up there to Emporia, Kansas, Wichita, Kansas, Olathe, Kansas, eventually into Kansas City, eventually crossing into Hannibal, Missouri, Jacksonville, Illinois, Springfield, Illinois, and then into the central Illinois, going up towards Pontiac, Illinois, and then eventually into the south suburbs of the city of Chicago. We're going to be taking it easy on the road, a few hundred miles a day here and there. Going to have a good time on the road, guys. It's going to be a good trip. So if you guys can hear me and see me, press the number 69. Say hello, enjoy the chat, enjoy yourselves on the road, King of the Free World, and say hello to each other. Enjoy the chat, enjoy the stream. I'll be coming on intermittently here and there, just coming on intermittently as I feel like it, here and there. I'm not going to be on the whole trip, but intermittently, hopefully, to drum up some support here. And if you guys can just enjoy the chat, enjoy the road. I can't see what you guys are saying. I got to keep my eyes on the road, but enjoy the chat. Say hello to each other. Just please show your token appreciation and support with a very minimal contribution of $5, $10, $15, $20. PayPal.me/Elvis Travels. I haven't got any support yet, and I appreciate your support, guys. Obviously, some of this fuel cost is big. Lisa Marie's doing good. Topped off brake fluid. Topped off the cool before I left. Put a quart of oil in. Power steering fluid is at good level. Tire pressures are fine, windshield is clean, headlights are clean, side mirrors are clean, and temperature on the rig is running great, battery meter is great, oil pressure is okay, normal, and we're on the road, guys. It's going to be a great trip, a positive trip. We're going to go back home to Chicago, see my mom, work, make some money, try to stay healthy, try to eat clean, try to lose some weight, reconnect with family, friends, make some money, and hopefully do this all over again. And this August will be 7 years and I'm full time in the rig. Hopefully gonna do some van projects. Mr. Rags, we'll see. and hopefully rejuvenate my online presence somehow. We'll see how that works. Right now, this is just a diary of my life, guys. The tried and true, the legendary Lisa Marie. Please pray for me, pray for my mom's health, pray for my health, and pray for the well-being and mechanical health of Lisa Marie. Tried and true rig, legendary 351 cubic inch Windsor V8, legendary 3-speed C6 4 transmission. And it's been a great rig. And compared to other rigs that are Dodge, this has been a great rig. I'm going to take care of this rig for a long time because it's my home. And I got to do whatever I can. Keep my home on the road. Please pray for me, guys. We're on the road. Got a long way to go. We're going to make it home. I'm confident this is going to be a good trip. Weather looks good. If the weather's bad, I'll pull over. If there's rain or storms, not sure what the forecast is over the country, but looks good here. Anytime we get tired, anytime we see any weather rain, definitely pull over and take a break. It's always good to be safe on the road. Always maintaining the maintenance elements of the rig. Checking tire pressure, checking brake fluid, engine oil fluid, transmission fluid, power steering fluid, brake fluid, power steering fluid. Making sure everything is okay on the rig, making sure we check our radiator level, coolant. Doing all the things you need to be safe on the road. One of the most important things in life is safety, guys. Never sacrifice your safety. If you're tired, pull over. If there's inclement weather, pull over. If there's a lot of traffic, pull over. If there's an accident, you don't want to waste time and gas, pull over. Take a break. Best thing to do, guys. Pull over and take a break. Keep safe on the road. Keep your spirits up. We're going to do a Red Bull energy drink. And hopefully, I'm crossing my fingers that we're going to make some progress tonight. Hopefully, get close to Santa Rosa, New Mexico, or closer. We are well rested. We are prepared. I have at least two weeks of water and food on the rig. I'm very well prepared, much more prepared than last time. The weather is much nicer here to be on the road, obviously, than being on the road in the wintertime. That's a positive. The only negative is gas prices are higher. As opposed to paying $2.70 a gallon, $2.75 a gallon, or $300 a gallon, I'm going to be paying $4 a gallon or more, and I'm getting into $1.450, so that's going to be a bad thing. But what can I do? Got to get home. I'm hoping that you guys can offset some of these costs. Give me a 69 if you guys can hear me, and I'm not on Bluetooth, so you guys hear me fine. So guys, give me a 69. I can't read the chat, I'm sorry. Gotta keep my eyes on the road. I got this trucker behind me. But anyways, my mirror keeps on going down here. So. Riding the road here. We're going to do okay on gas in Kansas. It's going to be good price. Oklahoma's going to be good. Missouri's going to be decent in gas. Dalhart, Texas. Emporia, Kansas. Olathe, Kansas. Hannibal, Missouri. Most of Missouri's going to be decent on gas. It's not really going to hit me hard until I get into Illinois. Jacksonville, Illinois, Springfield, Illinois. That's where it's going to pop up 50 cents, 50 to 60 cents. But it's going to be cheaper to gas up there anyway compared to getting close to the city of Chicago, because Chicago's mostly $5 or more. So it is what it is. Got a lot of truckers pulled up over here on the side of the road here, sleeping. Pull off. So we're gonna do decent. We're gonna do decent on gas for most of the trip, really between El Paso, Texas, Dalhart, Texas, parts of Kansas, most of Missouri. We're gonna be doing really, really good on gas. We're gonna be doing $4 or less a gallon. We're a little over $4 a gallon, which is not bad compared to what we're seeing with the prices here now in the country. And we're not really going to get hit hard on the gas until we get to Illinois, which from there is going to be a pretty short stretch going home. And those are the prices in Illinois anyway, $4.50 a gallon, $4.50 to $4.70 a gallon, $4.50 to $5 a gallon. So that's, it is what it is. We're in town right now. We're in a little town. I don't know what town we're in. We're passing through a little town here, and it's always good to bring your speed down to 35 miles an hour, because usually these little towns, that's what it is, it's 35 miles an hour. 30 to 35 miles an hour.
In 1/2 mile, turn left on St. Francis Drive.
But we're in a little desert town here, a little cute desert town. Coming up here on US 54. Let's see here. We're going to be turning left here because I think there's a split off over here on 54 and 70. So I'm going to get to the left lane. Cool little desert town, man. I'm in a little...
Turn left on St. Francis Drive.
Okay. It says make a left over here. US 54 and US 70, this is the people coming around here. So if you go to the right, you go to US 70, Redoso, Roswell, Mexico. From here, 54, you go to Corozo, New Mexico. So that's what we're doing here. 122 miles there, wow, long stretch here in the desert. Lots of trucks parked, resting. Lots of nice places to park here for trucks, wide open spaces, that's nice for truck drivers. And we're going in through a little town here, 40 miles an hour speed limit. There's going to be a long stretch here on 54, long stretch, guys. Beautiful driving in the desert here. 55 miles an hour speed limit. I want to get over these mountains and get it over with, and get over these little hills and get into where I got to get into here. We are 126 miles south of Vaughan, New Mexico. I know it gets kind of hilly somewhere around Rosa. We're gonna amp it up here a little bit. It's dark in the desert, guys, but we gotta get on the road and put some miles in there. I guess I'm gonna call it a quits probably around Santa Rosa, New Mexico, before that, give or take. We'll see, we feel good here. There's some sort of a light here. I don't know what this is. RV park here. Our battery voltage is fine, it's in 14s. Lots of wind. Good riding the road here, 54. coming into two lanes here. Highway 54. Looks like it's a little bit of an uphill bridge here. I think here where it gets into a little bit of a hilly country here. We're getting into the hills of New Mexico here. Lots of wind. And we're going over a bridge. Going over the bridge. Yeah. This is where it kind of starts to get a little bit hilly and twisty here. Getting into the hills. I want to get over these hills and get it over with. This treacherous part of this trip on the hills here, but we're going to get it done. We're going to get it done, guys. Temperature on the rig. You guys are on the road. Battery voltage really good. It's in the 14s. Battery is charging. Everything is good on the rig. My God. Please pray for me in Jesus' name. We're on the road. I'm going to be on here intermittently. I'm going to drive. We got a good start today. Went through El Paso, went down to Gordo. Hopefully we're going to get here, take a break around Santa Rosa, and do it all over again tomorrow. Take a nice break, get a good start. Hopefully the temperatures are going to go down, going north. We're still in May, so it shouldn't be that hot. It's not like we're in the summertime, so I hope the temperatures fall drastically. Get some good driving, some good sleeping. It's gonna be a good trip, guys. I feel confident, positive. Being confident, being positive is a very, very essential thing. Being prepared, being responsible. It's not all about just lounging away and being happy, you know. That's nice, but sometimes you gotta put the pedal to the metal. Be responsible, be positive, be productive. And like I said, we're gonna be on here intermittently here. We've got a long way to go, guys. I don't know if I'm going to do 366 miles tonight, but I'll probably do a couple hundred more. And then shut it down in Santa Rosa, New Mexico. And start all over tomorrow. Hopefully the temperature's going to be cooler going up into the plains. Working our way up into Dallas, Texas. Into the beautiful flat plains of the United States of America. And hopefully, right now we're in Tornado Alley, weather, so I hope I don't run into Tornado Alley. Because I'm not really sure what the forecast is for the whole country. But if we run into inclement weather, we will pull over. Take refuge. Looks nice and dry here in the desert. All always is. What's going on in the plains remains to be seen. We know May is a very active one. Into the desert, guys. Scary dark desert. It is what it is. Very scary. Not scary, but peaceful. Peaceful, safe. But remote. Looks like there's some sort of a light electronic breaker box here. Right way in, 1,500 feet.
It is what it is, guys.
guys. It is what it is. Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy. Nice riding the highway here. Dark highway. If I put my high beams on, it brings down, it really doesn't bring down my voltage, so I could probably do it here a little bit. If I put the low beams, it just goes up a little bit, so they're not really drawing much, so I can use it here. I'm over 14 volts here. Good ride here, man. It's nice riding with the high beams. You're getting about 100 feet of visibility here. As opposed to the low beams, you're getting very bad. Probably just, if you think about it, just about 40 feet. So, I'm going to keep the high beams on here. I think we're okay here. We're over 14 volts. It is what it is, guys. Good ride. We're going to get some good miles in here. Probably going to stop at Santa Rosa. Evaluate what's after that. Looking forward to getting into decent gas price in LR, Texas. Yeah. me get home, man. I'm crashing in way too long. Timing is right. Timing was right. Timing was the timing to get out. The heat was coming. It was coming pretty bad. And it was time to leave. And I'm prodigal in Chicago because I didn't get back home. It is what it is, guys. Online diary. What a long road trip. I'm going to overwhelm myself. Take a little bit at a time. And good riding road here. Smooth. Clear. Flat. More can you ask for? Not any high beams in your face. It's not a two-lane highway yet, so that's good. Good riding road. It's going to be good riding here all the way until you get into Delaware, Texas, you know. So, it's going to be good riding. I think this door isn't closed all the way, but I'll kind of slow down here a little bit. And, make sure it's closed and smack in the shelf. I see somebody coming up here, a truck driver.
Alright, we're getting into these little hills now here.
hate these hills. We're getting into these little hills here. Little foothills in New Mexico. I want to knock them out and get it over with. So my rig doesn't overheat in the daytime. Once I do that, it's going to sail again. Get rid of the hills in New Mexico.
Before we're going to be doing that on gas. 54
24 miles an hour, full gas mileage. When I get to Chicago, I really need to fix this exhaust pipe. How you doing, man? Nice to see you, brother. I can't really read the chat. I gotta keep my eyes on the road. But we're in New Mexico now. I have to shout out to New Mexico. Everybody, give me a 69 if you hear me. I need some gas. I have to ask for it tonight. My attempt to get $20 to pay out. It's a hell of gas, guys. It is what it is. It is what it is. Now the trucker, I think this is a trucker coming up. Gotta keep it at 54.